Okay, shalom everybody. We are starting this class before Pesach. It was a really amazing Shabbat for all of us. And Baruch Hashem, we have the class today. I believe everybody's very overwhelmed. We started with this short video of HaKadosh Baruch Hu Matzilenu Miyadam. Every time that we need, we pray, and Baruch Hashem, we have Rabbi in Israel. Very excited. We're gonna start this class, Tafshin Pei Daled, and let's hope from now on we're going to have just good news, amazing news and miracles, Be'ezrat Hashem. Bakasha, Rabbi.
Okay, shalom, shalom, everybody. I used to start this class for Pesach like this. No one understand what I did, but Pesach is pe, pe is mouth, sach is talking. That's the time to talk, okay, about everything, about the miracles, about our story, our history, and about the future. So that's the point that the holiday is so special, because the holiday is now, that's the beginning of the year, beginning of the Jewish year. That the year that according to the Torah, this is the first month, Achodesh Hazeh Lachem Rosh Chodeshim, the head of all the months. And this is the first festival, the first Chag that we have in Pesach. And Pesach is including, like in the root, you have everything. That the tree, the fruit, the leaves, the branches. Also, Pesach is everything is inside Pesach that we can learn and see that this is exactly the root of everything, and everything is depend on this holiday. So, if you want to know, there is like a secret of all the festivals of the Chagim that we have in front of us. They are mentioned and hint. There are hints and clue inside the word, the days of Pesach. Let's say, like you understand. You have the first day, just to tell you that we have, if you can see the board, I can show you the board that you have Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey, and Vav, and Zayin. And now we take the letters backward. Backward. So the last letter is Taf, before it's Shin, Ruesh, Kuf. Okay, and we have also that we have Tzadik and Pei and Ayin. Those are the letters that comes from. Those are the end of the letters. So Aleph, the first day of Pesach, become festival that start with the letter Taf. What's the letter Taf? What festival that we are not so happy in this day? Tisha Be'av. But the second day, the meaning of this year, Aleph is Yom, is Tuesday. Tuesday. And on Tuesday, the meaning of this, Tisha B'Av, be ready, it will be Tuesday. Tuesday, like the first day of Pesach is Tuesday, Aleph, it will be Tisha B'Av. The second day of Pesach, that is Wednesday, it will be Shavuot. Shavuot, Shavuot, the first day of Shavuot, that will be Wednesday. You have Wednesday, you have Thursday, you have a break, and you have Shabbat. That you have. Gimel, the third Wednesday, Thursday. Resh is Rosh Hashanah. Rosh Hashanah. The new year will be, there will be Tuesday, will be Thursday, and Friday, 3 days, and Shabbat. So, Gimel, the third day of Pesach, today is Thursday, it will be the first day of Rosh Hashanah. It will be Thursday and Friday, and absolutely Shabbat. When the people will tell you, how do you know that it will be Rosh Hashanah 3 days? Okay, now you understand. After that, every day, here you have the clue, because the class is very long, or you don't want it, then you will have the page that you can see that every festival, every holiday, every hag, okay, is connected, the entire year connected to the days of Pesach. Okay, you can take the letters Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hei, Vav, Zayin, just to let you know that Zayin, this is the seventh day. To this year, Zayin, the seventh day will be Monday. What will be in reality will be Atzmaut, Atzmaut, Hag Atzmaut. You have on the second, the seventh day will be Atzmaut. Okay, that the meaning of this, the seventh day of Pesach will be on Monday. So Atzmaut, be ready. Okay, you have Sunday, you have also Monday. Now you have Atzmaut, to enjoy the Atzmaut that we have here, that will be, it will be Monday. So you understand that is Pesach is the root of everything. So also this is the root of blessings, and very, very important concepts of the Judaism is inside this special holiday, this special Pesach that we have. That Be'ezrat Hashem, next Shabbat is called Shabbat HaGadol. What the meaning Shabbat HaGadol? You know, we say Shabbat is like a bride, is kala, is like a lady. Shabbat is not a man, is not a male, okay? It's female. Shabbat is female. So how we say Shabbat Gadol? Gadol, that's male, but Shabbat is female. So how come? Why you say Shabbat HaGadol? You have to say Shabbat HaGedola. HaGedola, no Shabbat HaGadol. But everybody says Shabbat HaGadol. So you can ask the people. They will let you many, many answers. Shabbat HaGadol, because the rabbi is talking a lot for Pesach, and so that is Gadol. Or there is Nes Gadol, big miracle it was there. But many, many things. But you have to understand about Shabbat HaGadol, okay, what the secret is inside Shabbat HaGadol. Very important to show that to the family. Very important. Please, I'm going to show you the secret and remember the secret that we are going to see here about Shabbat HaGadol, because it's not normal to say in Hebrew Shabbat HaGadol. We have to say Shabbat HaGedolah. So I'm going to write Shabbat HaGadol. Okay, I'm going to write. Shin, the letter Shin is like Shana. Shana, a year. Shana. Shanat, like year. Which year it was? The year that we went out from Egypt. That's the secrets. To remember the year that we went out from Egypt. Shin is Shana. Shana, Shana year. That's two. 2000. Bet is two. Aleph Bet. Tav is 400. Hagadol. What is Hagadol? What the numerical value of the word Hagadol? Okay, what the numerical value is 48. Hagadol, that's 5, 3, 4, 6, 13. 48. So, that every Jew has to remember which year now, that's very important to know how many years we celebrate Pesach. We celebrate that we went out from Egypt. We went out 2048. 2000 from the creation or from the that we count according to the Jewish count, that how we count 2448. This Shabbat HaGadol, remember, Shin Shavn Shana, Bet, that's 2400, HaGadol 48. You have 240. And today, what is today? Today we have Tav Shin Pei Dalet. Today is 5000. Today is 5784 minus. I hope that you can see. Minus, what minus? 2448. Because this is the year that we went out from Egypt. So how many years this year? How many years this year? Okay, if Livna can show us this, okay, that it will be 3000. I'm going to write. 3000. This year, 3330 and 6. Okay, you have to remember, you have to know how many years we celebrate Pesach? How many years? 3,336 this year. Eternal nation. That's the point. To tell us that everybody will remember to say Shabbat HaGadol. And not Shabbat HaGedolah, Shabbat HaGadol. Okay, that's exactly 2,438 48. That's the year that we went out from Egypt. Okay, and now this year, 336, that we can remember that. That just I give you like a clue that Abraham Avinu, when Hashem told him to leave his family and to go to Israel, it was exactly 1948. 1948 from the creation. It sounds like that you know this number, 1948, okay, that we come to Israel also. So you see, if you have really eyes to see the history that we live, history that not we were born a couple years ago or 10 years ago. We are eternal. We talking about eternal. We say Shabbat Hagadol. This is the year that we went out from Egypt to remember the year that not just to remember the past, to know now that how many years we are eternal nation. 3000 we celebrate Be'ezrat Hashem this year. We celebrate the 3,336 Seder from Egypt, that we went out from Egypt. So very, very important Pesach, this holiday, because this is the root. Okay, please participate. The children, the kids, just the time to transfer. That's like your parents, okay, gave you the idea that Baruch Hashem, you are Jewish, you are eternal nation. Okay, please transfer this to the kids when you are sitting there. Maybe they don't understand well about the 3,300 years, okay, but long time that we are here. And these, you can participate, you can give them, let's say, like a quiz, let's say, you tell them, this Pesach is Haga Prachim, Prachim, flowers, flowers. What the flowers of Haga Prachim? Okay, let's see the idea of Prachim. Okay, that's very easy for the kids. When you participate in, you know, I will give you a story about one Hasid. He wants to know the secrets of Pesach, let us say them. He went to his rabbi, he left his family, and he went to his rabbi, and he said, I came here to learn from you about Leil HaSeder. So he said quietly, and so whatever his rabbi does, whatever he said, whatever that, after they finish, almost they say, okay, go get shlufen. Now we finish. He said, no, I didn't learn anything. Whatever I saw, you rabbi, you just talk with your grandchild. I want to know about things that when you do that, what is the secret for them? The rabbi saying, no. This is the main point of Leil HaSeder, to be with your grandchild, to be with your child, to show them the tradition, what you learn That's exactly the main secret of Pesach. So you can ask them, also the kids, okay, you can play with them. They will not go to sleep. Tell them, you know that Chag HaPesach is Chag HaPrachim. Prachim is you know, Prachim is flowers. So you can tell them, you can tell us, you can ask them, what Prachim? Chag HaPrachim. Okay, now you understand. You have pay, the letter pay, please take this. Pay is like Pesach. Pay, Pesach. Resh is one of the regalim, regel. There we have three regalim, one of regel. And what chet? Chet is cherut. Okay, the freedom. You know, the entire world learned from us that freedom, never be slave. Exactly. Also, America established on this idea. You learn the history of America, that how it established freedom. And you know that also many, many concepts that we have Herut, Yod for Yod, that's Yod for Yetziat Mitzrayim, that the festival of Yetziat Mitzrayim. Maybe it's very easy. Matzot, Chaga Matzot. We have Matzot, we have Yetziat Mitzrayim, we have Herut. We have Regel, the festival Pesach, and hey, Chag HaAviv. HaAviv, the spring. Why we say Aviv? If you want to know the concept of Aviv, Aviv is Av, source of 12. 12 what? 12 months, that Aviv. Aviv is spring, but the Aviv, exactly that we have here, okay? Aviv, we have here the, okay, that Av, the source of 12 months. The source of 12 months, that Aviv. So that's very important to understand, and let's go deeper. Yes, kids are important. We said that we have to emphasize and to focus on with them, not just with us, not just with the food. The food is very important, absolutely. The tradition, everyone has his own tradition. It's very important, but very important to understand about the Haggadah that we are going to say about the Haggadah that we said about the Haggadah. What we said about the Haggadah? We said like this. I take the Haggadah. And we have four children. We have Ehad Hacham. Okay, you have here, if you want to see the pictures, each one draw another picture of Hacham, Rasha, and Tam, and Sheino Yodea Nishol. I'm going to say, how do you know that this person is smart, hacham, not tzaddik. You say hacham. Hacham is smart. Hacham is not tzaddik. Don't say hacham is tzaddik. Okay? Hacham, rasha. Rasha, wicked. What you are doing? Rasha. Tam, and there is Tam, Tom is quiet and what you will tell me, I agree. Okay. Hacham. Hacham, what he said. Ma ha'edot ba'chukim asher tziva Hashem Elokeinu etchem. Tell us, tell me, what are the rules, what are the mitzvot that we have to say? He is smart. He is asking questions. Very good to encourage the kids to ask questions. Don't let them. Also, you, my children, I encourage you always ask questions. Always ask questions. Don't let question. But maybe if you find the person that you can receive the answer, Baruch Hashem. Okay, so always ask questions. Hacham, ask questions. Rasha, the wicked, is a also. He like ask question. What the question? Ma ha'avodah zot lachem. What you are doing here? This Lela Seder, very strange. Very strange. What you are doing here? So the Haggadah said, you know why he is wicked? Because he said, Ma ha'avodah zot lachem, lachem. Lachem, lachem. That he said, no, it not belongs to me. Not belongs to me that lachem, what you are doing, you. Before that, he said, the Haggadah said that he is wicked. Why? He separated himself from the community, from the people, from the family, from the tradition. Okay, so he said, we learn from, he said, lachem, lachem, what you are doing, what you are doing, not belongs to me. Please, my family, my children, you are all my children. Please, let's be honest. Let's be honest. Let's read again what the wise person he said. Ma ha'edot asher tziva Hashem Elokeinu etchem. Etchem. What? It's the same. The same. Lachem. Or etchem. He separated himself from the community. Tziva Hashem Elokeinu etchem, etchem. There are many, many, answers for these questions, because the Rasha, the wicked, and the wise, they are almost the same, almost the same. So why you say to Rasha that he is wicked because he separated himself from the community and about the Hacham, he also said, Etchem, Etchem, you, if you understand, but Etchem, not me. Etchem. Big question. I told you that there are many, many answers. Okay, please wait. I'm going to explain. And you will enjoy, I hope, the answer. I'm going to call, you know that how many children I have? You know how many children? You don't know. I have 22 children. Well, we never know. 22 children. Yes, I have 22 children. You want to know their names? Okay, very easy. The first child, Aleph. The second child, Bet. The third child, Gimel. Yes, Tiv, Kuf, Reshin, Tav. Okay, all of them are my children. I'm going to call them. These are my children. Please come. Please come. Okay, they come. Here are all of them. You see them? I don't know, but I see them. Now, I am going to show you, and you build the idea by yourself. You know what the beginning is Aleph. What the end? Taf. What we have in the center, in the middle, we have Kaf Lamed Mem at the center. Follow me and you will enjoy. And when you say that to the people on the Seder, they will hug you. So, Aleph is the beginning. The end is Taf. Present is Lamed, Kaf, Lamed, Mem. Those are the letters. Now, pay attention what the Rasha, the wicked, what the Rasha said. What he wants. The past? No. The future? No, he doesn't care about the future. He doesn't care about the root. He cares about the present. Now, I want to smoke now. I want to drink now. No, I want now. He used the words lachem, that this lachem comes from the center, from the present. He likes to take advantage of the present. I don't care about the root. I don't care about the future. Yes, for that he consider a wicked, because he doesn't care about the roots. He doesn't care about the future. He cares about the present. The present is important, absolutely. But we don't erase other things. So that the Rasha, what the Chacham, the wise, said. I have, he said the word, which word he said? He said the word Etchem. You see here? Tziva Hashem Elokeinu Etchem. He used the letters Aleph and Taf and Kaf and Mem. What the meaning? I'm sure that you understand. What the meaning? He said, Etchem. I have Aleph. What Aleph? That the beginning. I have the roots. I have Anochi Hashem Elokecha. Anochi. I know that I'm Jewish, that I received the Torah, that I received the Ten Commandments on Har Sinai. I have Aleph. I have Aleph. Taf. What's Taf? Taf is I have also the future. I am looking for the future. Yes, I send my children and tell them there is goal. We are Jewish nation. We have future, not just now. And he said also to the wicked, wicked, pay attention. I have also the present. I have Kaf and Mem. Yes, I have also present. I am not somebody that outside the world. I have the roots. I have Aleph. I have also the Taf, the end. We say in Hebrew, Tikva, hope, Tachlit, Tachlit, that ends. Okay, I see the future. As a Hacham, Aroet HaNolad, I see the future. And I have also the present. I have also. You are a Shah. You are the wicked. Yes, you are the wicked. You want just the present. You don't care about the roots. You don't care about the future. You care just the present now, that you want to fulfill your desire now. Don't care about this, I don't care about that. I have also the present. That he used the word etchem. Etchem, pay attention. You have Aleph, you have Taf, the beginning, the end, and the center. That's why he considered, because if you don't think about this, that because the wicked and the smart and the wise, they are almost the same, but not in Hebrew. In Hebrew is very clear. Claro, we say in Spanish. Okay. Very clear. Okay, that etchem, that's very important, past, present, and future. That's the point that we understand. Okay, we start this Zoom with the story, the Hisha Amda. Okay, that we say this very important, the Hisha Amda. Okay, that also I didn't succeed to give you this before, and about a girl that she is one in our group. Okay, that I want to show you something about her. Okay, that she went yesterday, you see, she went yesterday where there is shelter, and she went with to protest, and she wrote the Hisha Amda Lavotenu Velanu. Okay, that you will see that a girl that she understands, because her mother, her father told her, we are eternal nation. And she said, Isha Shebechol Dor Vador, Omdim Alenu Lechalotenu, Vakadosh Baruch Hu Matzilenu Miyadam. Listen, listen to my story. I'm coming home, let's say 15th floor. I jump. And I say, wow, my children, listen. I jump and happy. Jump and happy. Happy and jump. Why you jump? What's happened to you? Tell us, what is the secret that you are so happy? I am telling them, you know, before I come home, it was about 50 people in the windows, everyone with gun, and shoot and on me, and they want to kill me. They said, you are crazy. Why you are happy? Why you are happy? And I continue to jump and happy. They wanted to kill me. I'm very happy. No, That's exactly what you do on the seder. You take the wine. Yes, Jad, you are with me. You take the wine and you say, Veish Elohe Hadilvan Amadalenu Lechalotenu Shebechol Dor Vador. They want to kill me in every generation, in every year, in every day, in every hour. They want to kill me. And I'm still happy? You are crazy. Why we do that? Why we do that on Pesach and we take the cup of wine and dancing and happy to say that every generation they want to kill us. Yeah, we say the Jewish people, they are not normal. Absolutely. Absolutely not normal. So, what they will ask you, your children, your kids, you are normal. You are happy, they want to kill you every generation, and you're happy. Now, the answer is going like that. Shelo ehad bilvad. Amad aleinu lechalotei. You have the page, I don't know where we live now, okay? Shelo ehad bilvad. What the meaning shelo ehad bilvad? Shelo lo ehad bilvad. What the meaning shelo ehad bilvad? Only one wanted to kill us. Who is that? Ehad bilvad. Shema Yisrael Adino Eloheinu Adino Yehod. Yehod, this is God. You know, we just finished Purim. You know, Hashem called Haman, please, please come here, stay here. I want to ask you, what do you want to do? I want to kill all the Jewish people from all the universe. You want to kill the Jewish people? Hashem said, I tried to kill them and I didn't succeed. I didn't succeed when I wanted to destroy the Jewish nation. Moshe came to me and he said, don't do that. And I didn't succeed. You, Haman, Iran, Iran, you want to kill the Jewish people. You want to kill Israel. Hashem said, you know, I'll give you a story. It was a bird. The bird made a nest in the coast. And the ocean came and destroyed the nest. The bird swore and said, you know, I'm going to dry the ocean. I'm going to take all the water from the ocean outside to the desert. And I take sand from the desert to dry the ocean. And the bird went to the sand and took one sand, a small one, and threw to the ocean. And took another, a little bit water, and throw it to the desert. And he wants to change. That's you, Haman. That's you. You are the bird that want to change the university, the universe. You change that they impossible to think about that. You know, by the way, how long it took from the day that Haman signed and to destroy the Jewish nation and they hang him? How long? Years? Months? Weeks? Hours? 72 hours. Not many people, they know that. 72 hours from the day that he signed to kill, to destroy the Jewish people, till he was on the tree. 72 hours. Ask you, Rabbis. Haman, Iran. What do you want? To destroy the Jewish nation? Okay. Why we are happy? Ve'hi she'amda, shelo echad bilvad amad alem. Because Hashem, that he is echad, he doesn't want to destroy us. Echad shelo echad. Hashem doesn't want to destroy us. Shelo echad, this is God. When Hashem decided that you will be eternal, that I am happy. You can do whatever. But Hashem doesn't decide to destroy. That's a law. How I know? You know, in the end of Seder, you finish, you ate Afikoman, and you start to sing. Eha ha Eloheinu, 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 Ken Hadar, Sheba Shamayim. Who is Ehad? You ask? Yes, many times we mention Ehad, Ehad, Ehad. Who is Ehad? Shelo Ehad Bilvan. Eloheinu. That's all. I am jumping with pleasure, with happiness. So glad. For that, I take and I am happy. Shelo echad bilvad. That's the secret to understand. And
אפשר
now
לשאול
let's
שאלה? סליחה?
go
אפשר לשאול
ahead.
שאלה?
No, now,
לא, לא,
Hashem.
לא, לגבי האחד הזה, הרי המשך השיר זה הקדוש ברוך הוא מצילנו מידם, אז הוא מציל אותנו מעצמו?
לא, הוא מציל אותנו בגלל שהוא לא החליט להרוג אותנו. בגלל
לא
שהוא
יחזרה.
לא החליט להרוג אותנו, הוא מציל אותנו מידם.
והקדוש ברוך הוא זה אותו אחד? כאילו הוא לא הורג אותנו והוא מציל אותנו? כאילו יש איזושהי
הוא
סתירה.
החליט לא להרוג, וכל מי שרוצה להרוג, הקדוש ברוך הוא מציל אותנו מהמן ומאיראן ומכל אחד. הקדוש ברוך הוא מציל אותנו. זה
אמן.
פשוט. בוודאי. אם כן,
תודה, תודה,
משום
סליחה.
שהקדוש ברוך הוא לא החליט להרוג אותנו, משום שהקדוש ברוך הוא החליט שאנחנו נשארים, אז מי שמנסה להרוג אותנו, הקדוש ברוך הוא דוחף אותם הצידה. אוקיי, סורי. Now,
תודה, סליחה.
אוקיי, you are more than welcome. So, now, we talk about, you remember the four children? Four children? How it's written, Libna, if you have that, if not, so just everybody will remember. How it said, Keneged Arba'a Banim, we have Ehad Chacham, Ehad Rasha, Ehad Tam, Ehad She'eno Yodea Lish'ol. Is this Hebrew? No. It's not Hebrew. So if it's not Hebrew, okay. So no, please, okay. Ehad Chacham, Ehad Rasha. What it says, Ehad Chacham, the meaning of this God is with the Chacham. Ehad Rasha, God is also with the wicked Jewish. Hashem loved the wicked Jewish. Ehad Rasha. Okay. Yes, thank you. Ehad Chacham, Ehad Rasha. Ehad Tam, Ehad She'eno Yodea Lish'ol. Hashem love every Jew in each level. Each level. He will be Chacham, will be wicked, will be Tam, will be She'eno Yodea Lish'ol. Hashem love. Hashem with them. Ehad is with them. Ehad with the Chacham, Rasha, She'eno Yodea Lish'ol. Hashem with every Jew, every Jew. He will be wicked, there will be whatever. Okay, because we understand in the end, you know how we said the bottom line. We end the seder and we ask, you talk about Ehad, Ehad, Ehad. Who is that Ehad? Ehad Eloheinu shebashamayim uvaaretz. We have to prove. We have to prove. Now we go to the other page and we see the word Shachrit. Now, what they say? Yes, leave now with the before you try this page. Thank you. Okay, I don't know. No. Okay, Shachrit. Okay, that we have not this, please. Okay, that we have the page you tried before. Okay. Now, wow, that's good. Perfect. How it is said that all the students of the rabbis, they came and they knock on their door. They say, rabbis, what you are doing now? You still talking and telling the stories of Egypt? They say yes, but they told them, no, enough, enough, enough. That's the time to say Shema Shachrit, Kriyat Shema Shel Shachrit. That's the time to say Shema Yisrael. What the meaning Shachrit? Now you have all those four children. In the word Shachrit, you find Chet is for Chacham. Resh, that's for Rasha. Yes, he is a son. He's our child. He's part of our body. He's Jewish, even his Rasha. And we have Tam also, the Taf, all the green, and we have She'eno Yodea. Together, all these letters are together, Shachri. That's the time united. to united, yes, also in Israel now. I don't want to cry, but you understand. All of them are important. No one that you can tell that he is wicked. No. They don't understand. They don't know the tradition. They don't know the treasure that we have. Here, that's the time to connect everything. That you are, we are united together. All those children, that it's written in the Haggadah, they are one unit. Don't say that's Russia. No, God forbidden. You never know what this Russia does. It's what they do million times. Hashem knows. Hashem look in the heart. Hashem not look at the hands and the smile. That's not enough. Okay, Hashem look on the heart at what we have. So we have to be united. That's Igiya's man. He kroshema. What li kroshema? To say Hashem Ehad, Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Ehod. United, everything, everybody has to be united in Pesach. That's the festival that we are going to celebrate. Be'ezrat Hashem. And we are going also to finish when we eat the Afikoman. Also there is secret there. Afikoman, very important. That the last bread that we eat in the Seder, and after that we say Birkat HaMazon. They also we learn about the beginning, the roots, and now we are going to talk about the Afikoman. We have good opportunity when we eat the Afikoman. When we eat the Afikoman, to think about this word Afikoman. Afiku is take out. Afiku. Afikoman is gifts from Hashomayim to bring us from the Shamayim, that we have gifts. Gifts from the Shamayim. What the gifts from the heaven when we eat the Afikoman. Afikoman, you have that now, okay? Thank you. Afikoman, okay? That's, you have that to remember. Afikoman is two, Afikoman. You take, you can check 287. 287 is the word rofe. The meaning of this bread of healing. And this is bread of refuah. It's like medicine. That medicine that comes from Hashem. Rofe. And also, if you have refuah, Baruch Hashem, and you want something else, you can receive a lot of money. Hakesef bemazal gadol. That also the numerical value 287. That's well, good luck. And 287, that's what Hashem promised Abraham Avinu. And we emphasize that. אנוכי מגן לך הגנה. אנוכי מגן לך, השם promise us that he is our shelter. אנוכי מגן לך, to remember this, that you be protected. And after that, if you have, okay, you want more children, yes, Afikoman is also Ken Yirbe, that the promise of Hashem, that the Jewish nation will be many, many, many people, Ken Yirbe. Ken Yirbe segula for children and also for Hinuch, educate the children. Okay, here we are going to tell you, Livna and Jad and me, we are triple here, that we want to bless you.
And
with
Bracha join in Israel.
Bracha, Bracha, I didn't see, sorry. Where is
Where
Bracha?
Is Bracha?
Also, Bracha, please show yourself, okay?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize it was, I forgot just to open it.
Okay, we have many, many people here helping us and helping the families, that helping me, okay, that I help them. Thank you for your help through the what you send. Livna can tell you about the families, that I support them, and Baruch Hashem, okay, your support, that this class that we have here, 40 people at least, that they learn and they teach their children and they continue the tradition, the treasure of our tradition, to enjoy the tradition, to be happy with this cup of wine and dance with happiness. The Hishe Amda, Hishe Amda, Ravotenu Velano. Yes. How many years? How many years? This festival. Yes. Thank you, Nira. Thank you. Absolutely, you remember 3,000, 300. Okay, that you know, if you have 5 minutes, just to tell you a story. Okay, I went with them. We finished the class. If somebody wants to leave, okay. We went to Romania in the summer, and where you go, you pass the border, okay, and they sign the passport. And he said to me, which year you born? I said, 1945. And which land, which country you born? I said, Israel. Said, I know history. No Israel, 1945. No Israel. That's your passport is fake. I'm not going to let you to go in. I said, you don't give me to go in? He said, because your passport is fake. It's not real. It cannot be 45 and Israel. So you know what I did? I stand, and there was a big line behind me. You have to listen. You know Israel when it was 3,325 years. It was in that year that I remember. And I continue to tell him. He said, enough, enough. Why you come here with this university to tell us stories? Okay, go in. Okay, so he gave me the passport. When I came back to go out from Romania, they let my wife to go to the airport, to the plane. But for me, no. I said, why no? Go to the police. My wife said, "What did you do that the police, the first time in police?" What? I said, "I don't know. But I know that I did nothing." That so, why it's not signature in the passport? Where? How did you come here to Romania? I said, "I came with my wife, the same." No. So I. They said, no, there's something strange here. No signature in your passport. So I said, oh, maybe it was a problem. Yes, I remember. Okay, they said, we are going to check with this officer that it was maybe he forgot, maybe. So they called him. He saw me. He said, 3,000. 325 years, this man I remember. So he remembered the number, but this year is 3,336 years. Bezrat Hashem, continue. Don't be afraid. Strong. You are Jewish. Thank you. Chag Sameach. All the best.
Be happy, be
Amen.
Angel, yeah.
Jewish. Be
Yes.
happy, be Jewish. Okay, I would
Yasher
like
Korach. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. Chag
Torah, thank you, Rabbi.
Rabbi, I would like to thank many people here that really are sponsoring. Thank you, Gabriela and
Yes,
Elvira.
please,
And
please,
many
please.
people that are here that I didn't see because we have some pages here. Thank you for joining. Thank you for supporting all these people and the families that Rabbi takes them to the supermarket and say, buy what you need for the holiday. And then he pays the bill. You are
Wow.
helping really
Oh.
a lot of families in Israel, and we thank you very much for helping and doing all this
Explore.
support. We are I'm going to share
Explore.